Hello, this is Nathaniel Oxford, and I want to share with you my tetrachord warm-up exercise. This is a warm-up exercise that works for all instruments and all levels of players. So if you're an intermediate level player, there are things that you can use in here and you get started with this right away. If you're a professional level player, this is something that I used for a long time actually as a quick warm-up. Like when I was going from gig to gig and I wanted a quick way to warm up on my instrument, hit all the notes, all the keys, and practice focused tone, different articulations, different ranges of my instrument. I could do this in a couple minutes and I was ready to go. So if you're just learning your scales, like if you're in middle school, high school, let me tell you, this is a shortcut. I'll explain a little bit more, but let me go ahead and demonstrate the tetrachord warm-up exercise first. So that's the simplest version of the tetrachord warm-up. If you've downloaded the sheet, I just go from the C column all the way down and then back up to the F sharp column and all the way down. You'll notice at the bottom of the C column, it says G flat equals F sharp. Remember, those two notes are the same key on the piano. So if you keep going through the whole sequence, it follows the circle of fourths or the circle of fifths. And every time we do it, we add a flat. So by the time you get around to B, you would actually be, if we didn't change it from G flat to F sharp, you'd be playing a C flat. And then by the time you got back to C, you'd be playing a D double flat. And that's ridiculous. So you got to have somewhere to change over to the enharmonics. Here's why this is a shortcut to learning scales, because major scales are just two tetrachords stacked one on top of the other, and each tetrachord follows the pattern whole step, half step. So if you play mallet percussion, if you play piano, you can actually go and you can see where you're skipping a key, and then you're going to the adjacent key. And if you just take the tetrachord that you starts on C, for example, and the one that ends on C, that's a C scale. Take the one that starts on A flat and the one that ends on A flat, and that's an A flat scale. If you learn the tetrachords, just learn that whole step, half step pattern, and do it all the way around all 12 notes of your instrument, you'll learn all 12 scales, and you'll get the fingering patterns down or the sliding position, the patterns, because these are all in patterns. If you play a clarinet or if you play a string instrument, there are certain fingerings you're going to find work better than others. I may do an update to this later on where I put some fingering tips on here, but right now I really want to focus on how it works for trombone, or just maybe you can figure out on your own. This sheet, again, is down in the video description, so go ahead and download it and try it out for yourself. When you get back around to the C, if you're a brass player, maybe you want to go and start practicing your higher notes with it. Maybe you want to switch over instead of doing it. Maybe you want to do it really legato, or you want to do it really staccato, or you want to do a certain rhythm pattern on it. You could do that, right? Right? You could do use it to do anything. You could go down, straight down, all the first notes. That's a really good exercise too, right there. In fact, there's a warm-up exercise I learned from a great bass trombonist named Doug Nierman locally here, and that it's just a circle of fifths exercise that goes like this. And so I started on C, and now I'm at the second thing, but I went through 13 notes to get to the second thing. So you could go down the first notes of it. In fact, I could maybe take my cell phone and do a record myself playing a drone on the first note of each tetrachord group. And then I could play it back to myself and just play the tetrachords with it. Right? And just do it that way. You could do a duet, do a partner practice play date with a friend, do it that way. So hopefully this is really helpful to you. Tetrachord warm-up exercise.